I'm Tim McBride, and I'm going deep into the puppy underground and checking out what life is like after the Puppy Bowl. I will encounter this vicious beast. And let me tell you, her story ends in tragedy.
Well, we were real excited to bring Lexi to the Puppy Bowl. It's one of the biggest events of the year. Been training for it for how long now? How long? 4 months. And, she's just not the same after the Puppy Bowl. She lost. She knows it. She's a devastated little pooch. And it's hard to love something so much and to raise it. And then, you know, one event changed its whole entire life. I mean, depression's a big thing in dogs. They understand a lot more than people, you know, give them. When she came back, potty training also just, it went out the window. Went out the back door, you know. She used to be well trained. And, you know, now she just piddles and poos wherever she pleases. And, it's affected the lifestyle around here, you know. Shut up. I hate you. I love my pups. Someone, kiss daddy if you love him. It's just changed. Things have changed between us.
Ball State's premier comedy talk show.
The only talk show.
Yes, we're awesome. Thank you so much for spending the night with us. Later on in the show, we'll be talking to Zach Huffman and Ashley Cox. They're actually going to be traveling to Sochi, Russia as a part of the Winter Olympics as representatives of BSU at the Games. So that'll be pretty interesting.
Yeah, I'm interested to talk to him.
Yes, but first, let's talk about this week. Did you watch the Super Bowl last night?
Yeah, unfortunately I did, and it was probably the least entertaining Super Bowl I've ever seen.
Yeah, I would say that the Puppy Bowl was more entertaining and more competitive.
Mm-hmm. Probably.
Yeah. We actually have a lot of animal news to report on this week. Oh, and some Taliban news.
Oh, well, animals and Taliban, there's some variety for you.
Well, if you didn't know, the Taliban's broke. After fighting for more than decades in a long war, they've gone belly up. But they're not too worried, because next week, the Taliban leaders are meeting up with Obama to discuss a bailout.
Typical.
Yes.
Thanks, Obama.
You would. You totally would, wouldn't you? Gosh. A storm that struck all parts of the UK is now being called Cat-NATO. All parts of the UK? Is that right?
I mean, it's a small
Most
island.
Of the UK.
It's an island.
Yeah, it's something. Large amounts of feral cats were swept up by this storm, and they even seen flying through the air. And I've seen the footage, and just let me tell you guys, it was a cat-astrophe.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, not to be confused with a cat-astrophe.
Oh!
No, he did it! No! 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 Oh, wow! Jacob, did you hear about the Mexican waterfish?
No, I've never heard of this.
Oh, really?
Yeah. What happened to it?
Well, it's more of a description thing.
But is it extinct or what happened?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, of course.
Well, so what did
it's
it look
like? It's a Mexican waterfish.
It can't
survive in Mexico's water.
It never existed to begin with.
Yeah, exactly.
So what did it look like?
Yeah, they're described as being an ugly creature with a slimy tail, curls in its mouth, a creepy smile, you know, appendages, drags itself across the bottom of a lake, you know. It kind of reminds me of Tom Ford's spirit animal.
Rob Ford. I get
Mayor
it confused,
Toronto.
Too. Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and speaking of Toronto, Justin Bieber has turned himself into the police. And word is, Bieber fans can be seen outside of his jail cell holding signs that read, "Free JB!" For Justin's sake, let's hope he doesn't have a dyslexic roommate. Cellmate. He's gonna be busting out of jail to go get himself a free JB. That's what he's doing. Good thing Bieber is back in Toronto, because over 100,000 Americans signed a petition to deport Justin to his native Canada. And there was also a petition to save Bieber, but it only got 1,500 signatures. Can you guess why that is?
Probably because you have to be 18 or older to sign.
Got him! Wow! Oh, buddy, you better watch out for that one. The Winter Olympics began this week in Sochi, Russia, and news sources around the world are calling it the most corrupt Olympic Games in history. That is, of course, a real positive bump for the Russian image, don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're the worst.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back, everyone.
If you're like some women and some creepy men in America, you've probably come to worship the cultural phenomenon that is One Direction. The group has risen to fame as quickly as the days of Jagger and the Stones, even though they look like a bunch of pre-adolescent girls. But there is more to their story. There was one member of One Direction that actually went the wrong direction. This is the story of Billy Loveseat.
Billy was a bit of an odd bloke in school, but you know, he started shaving in primary school, fourth grade, I think. But he had this weird thing when he'd wipe the erasers off his pencils, and I don't know, but you know, he really could sing. He did a rendition of Welcome to the Jungle for a high school talent show, and he was sweating up a storm, but damn, it was great. It was really good.
Harry said, "What now? That's a load of bull." Yeah, I was a little hairy, but that doesn't mean I couldn't be in their boy band. I forgot having body hair meant that I couldn't be a musician. You tell that to any member of Nickelback or Creed. Now there's talent.
There's probably a lot of hairy fairy, but you know what? They're probably not even going to tell you or mention that I wrote What Makes You Beautiful hungover on a Carl's Jr. on a Tuesday.
I think it was really the drinking that spelt the end for him. There was a show where he drank 17 strawberries backstage, and it was a riot. He drank like a divorced dad, and especially when we threw him in with the dance routines. That's when it really ended for him. And the man couldn't dance. He danced like a car lot dummy, one of those inflatable car lot dummies. But and quite frankly, he smelled like garbage.
I like to have a few before I sing, but you know what? So did Elvis, and so did Kurt Cobain. Look at them. They're both doing just fine. You know, I never really was a fan of Niall. He's kind of creepy, frankly, and he looks like someone dropped a bowling ball on his head, or a seagull took a crap on it or something. There's always one member of every boy band who's getting outcasted. I'm like the Joey Fatone, if you will, of One Direction. Except I'm not a... I don't have a Superman fetish.
He was always a little bit too much to handle. We could never get through a rehearsal without him wanting to go to the horse track with the Chuck E. Cheese in whatever town we were staying in.
You know, Chuck E. Cheese, they also have terrific pizza. So, you know, maybe I did things a little bit differently, you know, snorting drugs off a 14-year-old's chest, you know, eating the Snickers before a show or seven. You know what? I'm all about the music, baby. I'm the same guy who I was before. I'm making an album now with the guy who made the Gunman Style. What's his name again? William Hung. Talent.
Wherever Billy is, you know, I just hope he's okay. He's doing all right. He hits me right here, you know, him not being here. But, brings a little tear to my eye.
Woo! Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Man, those British people just have lovely accents, don't they?
They do. Some of them sounded like a Boston accent.
Yeah,
I don't know.
An
Maybe
Ireland
they're becoming
accent.
More Americanized.
Yeah, it's very sensual indeed. I like it.
Sensual?
Sensual.
All indeed. Right. Well, that's your preference.
Welcome back, everyone. Please welcome our next guest, Zach and Ashley from BSU at the Games. Please welcome everyone. Okay. Give them a hand, everybody.
Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, Ashley, you thought this wasn't going to be on television.
No.
So,
Megan lied to me a little bit.
Surprise! Yeah. You're on TV.
Megan, one of the crew members, lied, so that's always good.
Those are some great shirts, by the way.
Yes, thank you.
And they are for
our trip to Russia,
which is BSU at the Games.
That's correct.
So, tell us, this started when? Like the last Olympics in London?
Yeah.
And that was the first time BSU at the Games, was begun?
I guess you could say it like that. I mean, that was the first time it was kind of kicked off and skyrocketed. And it's ever since, they've had the students of the immersive learning. You know how Joanne Gora likes to immerse learners.
I like to be immersed.
I can throw words around.
Yeah, there we go. There we go. But I mean, about 40 students went to the London Games, but Sochi, we've got 24 students coming there.
So now, select group.
Is it because of like the regular Olympics were bigger at all, do you think, than the Winter Olympics would be? Is that why they would send
more
people?
I mean, they're both the Olympics, either
right.
way
yeah,
you look
I know,
at it.
But like, I think less people go to the Winter Olympics. Less people are interested in the Winter.
I
haven't seen any polls by it, but that's just what I've felt.
I mean, if you want to compare financially, Putin's spending like $30 billion more than
Well, yeah, they got to clean up the city.
Well, he's basically, an evil villain, so yeah. He has all the money in the world to work with. So when do you guys leave?
We're leaving tomorrow now. We were supposed to leave Wednesday, but since this huge winter storm's coming, they're shipping us off tomorrow.
Oh, so when this airs, you'll be over
yep.
there. And you won't know what's going on here.
When this airs, we will have experienced a night over in Amsterdam, if that says anything.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, it does.
What does our audience exactly. think of that?
Well, we know what he thinks. Yeah, Amsterdam.
Yeah.
Maybe you'll just get stuck there, and you won't have to go to Sochi.
Yeah. What a shame.
Yeah. I was walking by, and I heard somebody talking on the phone saying, oh, yeah, my flight leaves tomorrow. And I'm like, where could you possibly be going, like, on a Tuesday?
And they're going to Russia.
Exactly. Yeah, going to Russia.
So what are you guys doing as a part of this immersive learning? What kind of students are going?
We have PR students, journalists, videographers, photographers. What do you classify as? You're kind of both.
I'm a little bit of
you're
everything.
You're all of the above. So.
A lot of broadcast stuff. So.
All right.
So what do you guys do? Are you writing stories? And where do those stories go to?
Yeah. Well, I'm the PR person. So I'm taking the stories and pitching them to local media that I think would be interested in running them. And right now we have partnerships with WTHR, the Colorado Springs Gazette. Who else are we working with?
We're still working with CNN. Last time some stuff was published on the Huffington Post. Mm-hmm. I think you were working on BuzzFeed.
Yeah, I really, really want to get on BuzzFeed. I've talked to their sports editor.
Are you doing a survey?
Yeah, well, no. Oh.
That's all they do.
Yeah. For some reason, I want to get some kind of funny video up there, but I don't know what I want it to be yet, so we'll see.
So you'd rather get a funny video than like a news article?
No. Maybe you'll see Putin with no shirt on.
Yeah.
That would be perfect.
There we go.
That would be good. So what are you guys looking forward to most? Like what Olympic game? Well, Winter Olympics, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. None of the regular stuff.
Well, I'm going to the women's Russia versus Germany game or hockey game. So I think
that sounds brutal.
Insane.
The only thing that's worse I could think is a Canadian women's team.
The USA women's hockey team is surprisingly beautiful, actually.
Do they have all their teeth?
Yes, they do.
That's amazing. Are you sure it's not just like fake? Like
most of them aren't from Muncie.
that would explain why.
Nobody's putting corn in their jaws.
There you
jaws.
Go, yeah, precise. Right. Uh-huh. But I'm excited. I get to go to the men's Slovakia versus U.S. hockey game and ski jumping, and then most importantly, curling.
Curling is awesome.
It makes no sense.
Exactly.
I like to pretend I'm curling when I'm mopping my floor.
There you go, with the mop.
It makes it fun.
So do you guys get to go, you get to pick which games you go to or what?
Pretty much whatever tickets were left whenever I picked.
Oh, okay.
So are you the only school that does, are we the only school that does this?
Really?
Sure.
Really?
Yes. Really?
From what we know, yeah.
Wow, that's pretty innovative.
Very immersive.
Well, you know, yeah.
Much immersion. Such innovative.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
So let's take a little, okay, so we've talked about this. Now, how do you feel going over? Do you feel safe going over to Sochi, yeah. Because just months ago it was the bombings at Volgograd, and that's just, you know, 200 miles away from where you guys are going. So is there...
Well, 200 miles is a long way.
Yeah, exactly.
But there's been threats. Haven't there been terrorist videos? And
yeah, they call them the Black Widows.
I should join this gang.
All women.
Curl,
they are. No,
it's all women.
Oh, really?
It is. Is it all women?
I could be their Charlie.
There's a pool player named Black Widow.
It is Black Widow, yeah, a pool player. But they call themselves the Black Widows because they are people whose family, their husbands or their kids were killed by Russian militants. And so now they are acting as suicide bombers. And the big report, and the big thing is that two of them are suspected to be living in Sochi right now.
Wow.
Am I worried? No, I'm fine. There are some people that are worried, but I mean, let me tell you, the university's taking every precaution that they can, and I mean, like I said, we're on a cruise ship, so worst comes to worst, you just pull a Captain Phillips and walk up to the deck and say, I'm the captain now, let's get out of here, you know, so.
Just get on out of there.
Exactly. But I feel safe. I don't know. I can't answer for Ashley.
Yeah, I'm not very worried. I feel like Putin has, I would not try to go against Putin, especially because
those
like,
Black Widows are so scared of Putin.
Well, like, I mean, I guess in Russia, they're like, here, if you got in trouble, it's like, oh, we'll put them in jail or something. In Russia, it's like, we're gonna take them out back and shoot them. So
yeah, I mean, they do things a lot.
Things are a little more serious there, and I'm more worried about not having good Wi-Fi. Yeah.
It's a legitimate problem.
Yeah. It's a real issue with what I'm doing there. So,
how do your parents feel? Because I know we're invincible, but how do are your parents worried?
Yeah.
I would say that's the biggest issue is the parents. You know, they're all freaking out a little bit, but you know what? In the long run, I mean, they're excited for us too at the same time.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, I'm sure you, as a journalist, there's a little bit in you that's like, if something does happen, I'm there to cover it. I mean, to say that.
Exactly. But the university set a policy that if anything does happen and we're caught running to the scene to take pictures, we get flown back to the United States on our own dime and possibly kicked out of the university.
Well, so wow. Are you really going to let them hold you back from trying to be a journalist, trying to be who you are? Go cover that story. Screw it. Right?
As we're really? Broadcasting yeah. on university-owned everything. Screw the university.
But really, if you did get that great story, do you honestly think they would kick you out of the university?
The issue with that is there's going to be so many media already over there.
Yeah, of course.
The story from our end, people aren't going to turn to BSU at the games and be like, man, they got that coverage right there. That's who I
know. BBC, Al Jazeera, CNN, BSU.
And NBC, yeah, right. Exactly.
That's very true. And the university knows that, and that's why it's more just to protect you.
True.
I mean, that would be...
It'd be something great to cover, but at the same time, I don't want to threat getting kicked out of the university.
Exactly.
And have to sit in front of Terry King and plead my case. Yeah.
And
you know?
I'm assuming you don't speak Russian either.
No.
So that would probably become an issue.
Exactly.
Have your advisors, like, did they want you to learn Russian? Or
we have two students who are very fluent in Russian that are going with us.
Okay.
So we do have two translators. Some of us were given tablets to take with us, and the tablets have installed on them both Google Translate and another app that the university developed or something that allows you to take pictures of any signs and it'll automatically translate it for you and any speech.
Yeah. They're blocky letters. Yeah. They have one font over there and it's just evil.
Yeah,
it really is.
Just try not to talk to anybody. I'd just be like, okay.
Yeah,
be a typical American. Don't learn the culture. Don't assimilate. Just, you know,
just go and have a good time.
The one thing that I always thought was interesting was, you know, people in America, they're always like, what the hell? We got this kid over here taking pictures of everything from out of the country. I'm like, that's going to be me and tomorrow. You know
exactly.
what I mean? I'm going to be that one guy that takes pictures of everything, and they're going to be like, oh, my God, who the hell is this guy?
It's always odd when you know you're the tourist.
Yes,
like you see
exactly.
tourists here, and you're just like, oh, look at this guy. But then you know that you're going to be that guy someday.
So Sochi is it's a resort town, right?
Now it is.
Yeah.
Well, no, but I mean before, it was that's like the most tropical place. Which is weird to say,
in Russia.
It's the most tropical place. Isn't that where Putin has a vacation house?
Something like that, but I mean, it's...
They had to bring in snow, right?
Yes, they had to truck in, they had to save snow from previous time, but I mean, it's 50 degrees there now, so we're, you know, it's like we're going down to Florida. So I'm excited.
Cool. That's
Florida with threat of Black Widows and language yeah. you don't understand.
A little bit. And yeah. the beach doesn't have sand, but it's okay. It's like a rock. But you know,
very nice. So BSU at the games. Do you guys have a Twitter that we can follow you guys at?
Yeah, we have Twitter, Facebook, Vine,
Instagram. Plug away, please. This show is yours now.
All of them are at BSU at the games. You can follow us on any of them or our website, BSUatthegames.com.
So all of them are really simple, just at BSU at the games.
Same thing everywhere.
All right, and so we can follow you guys and see what you're up to. I'm sure you guys will be posting pictures, video links, stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. We already are.
All of the above. Yeah, we already have things going.
Hey, say hello to Sean White for me.
I will.
I hear he's
and more importantly, be safe.
Yeah,
please.
Be safe.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it.
We'll be right back, everyone. that's super exciting.
Today on The French Chef.
While you make it, you're going to learn several.
Hey, do you mind?
Oh, yeah, sorry, dude. This new eco-friendly Sun Chips bag is super noisy.
Oh, okay, well, it isn't going to help me sleep for my test.
I'll be quiet as soon as I get it open, man.
Hey, what's going on in here?
All right, look what you did now. You're waking up the neighbors. Can you just keep that bag open?
I'm trying, man. This bag is really
open the bag. Come on, Jake, just open the bag.
I'm trying to get it open.
Oh, fellas. What is going on in here?
You woke up the RA, you idiot!
I'm trying to get this bag open. I'm
Jake,
sorry.
Just open
the bag. I can't get it
Come
open.
Come on, man. Just open the bag.
Jake, open the bag.
I'm trying
right
to
now.
Get it open.
Open it.
I'm trying.
Come on, man. Just
I'm
open the
trying
bag.
To get it open.
Open the bag.
Open the bag.
I can't do it. What? What's going on?
Jake,
open
the bag. Jake, open it.
Hey, you guys be safe
right.
in here.
Just let it Sun Chips, okay? New eco-friendly bag is louder than ever, but it's worth the racket.
Was it worth it?
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in tonight. That is the end of our show. Everyone at BSU at the games.
Right, follow
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Follow
them
on Facebook, Twitter,
lots
MySpace.
Lots of good stuff.
Napster, Friendster, DatPiff, Spotify, endorsements.
I don't know if I would go that far, but follow them because it's a different perspective on the games and it's probably more interesting to read. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I would say
I'd rather read them than some 60-year-old old fart that's seen 50 different Olympics.
Yeah, no.
That was a generalization, but.
Yeah. Thanks for coming out, everybody. We'll see you next week.
See ya.